knows how you come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with. That's me. Well,
I walk back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie. White in the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro. I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I will slap you.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Black as the ace of spades, but 100% American.
Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
United the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We're also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. I read this report a couple of days ago, and it literally made me sick. Really. I threw up after reading this particular story that I'm about to share with you right now. And it goes to show, how sick this country has become and how evil is in the forefront of our lives, and that most people, or many people, are promoting evil over good. And if this continues, I don't see how we're going to turn it around, because once you corrupt the next generation, the next generation is over. This story made me sick. It really did. This is from The Blaze. Margin ban spells Trayvon during a college football halftime show. The Alabama State University margin ban spelled out Trayvon. And you know who Trayvon was, right? Trayvon was the thug down in Florida that Joyce Zimmerman killed. And godless blacks have turned Trayvon in the black community. Normal people are not seeing him this way. I recognize that, just in the black community. But they have taken a thug who were not raised by two parents who want a pot-smoking, gun-toting thug and turned him into a hero in the black community. Now, if I can't see how anybody see that as being a good thing. They would take someone like Booker T. These same people would take Booker T. Washington and turn him into a thug, a Uncle Tom, a sellout, but they would take a thug, wannabe thug, untrained thug, and make him into a hero. So at the Alabama State University football team during halftime, you had all these people go out into the football field and spell out Trayvon's name, and they stood up and applauded and saluted him. The Jackson State University announcer says, "Rise and salute Trayvon Martin," and they did. This is the same person that called himself, Trayvon did, "At No Limit Nigger." That was his Twitter name. And the margin ban at a predominantly black school is honoring a thug, a wannabe gangster. And then when these young people see this and they take on to it, they fall for it, they become adults and don't survive in life, they're going to blame it on white people. They're not going to blame themselves for this. Here's a soundbite on that.
Thank you.
Now, they all stood up, from what I can see, they all, and saluted the life of Trayvon Martin. What life? The life as a thug? The life as at no limit nigger? The life of smoking pot, taking pictures with a gun, tattoos everywhere? What life are they celebrating? This, no wonder the black community or black people are suffering. And I've told you over and over again, it's due to the lack of morality. Anybody with any more sense at all would not do this. Stand up and celebrate Trayvon life in honor of Trayvon Martin. And not one of those people can tell you anything good Trayvon Martin did. Nothing. Isn't that amazing? This is what black people do. They celebrate everything that's wrong. I said years ago that they now call evil good and good evil. This is at the Jackson State University. Saluted Trayvon Martin. And they out there in the field with his name spelled out. The folks in the stands or audience, whatever you call those folks, are standing up and saluting a thug. I am at no limit nigger. That's what Trayvon called himself. And they're going to blame the results of these actions, their actions, will be negative. And they're not going to take responsibility for themselves. They're going to blame it on Whitey. And then Whitey going to try to appease them by not telling them the truth about their own issues, what they need to do for themselves. Isn't that amazing? And they have no shame about it. Not one iota of shame about being wrong. And, oh, they were playing an uninspiring rendition of Amazing Grace, if you didn't pick that up. It's amazing that these people are still alive, to be honest. I'm surprised God just hasn't taken lightning and just wiped these folks out. Back in a moment.